get to say, well, I believe it this way and you believe it that way, do I? Not anymore. No, he's given us truth. He's given us light. And this light can't be argued with, really. Not to hold any water. You can argue with it all day if you stay in the realm of reasoning. But this light and this truth just simplifies things. It makes everything clear. And I'm so thankful for that. I'm so thankful that there's a rest. You know, just a few verses down from what we were reading there in Proverbs that Kim and I was reading, it said, rest in the Lord. Rest in the Lord. Wait patiently for him. And he's given us rest. You know, the natural life in and of itself and doing things by just our flesh and our ability and our great mental capacity makes you tired. But there's something about living life in the Spirit. Recognizing that I'm crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live. Yet not I, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God. By faith. It's all by faith. And by faith, things are easy. Jesus made those Pharisees upset often because he made things easy. And he made things clear. And it messed them up because they worked long hours trying to make things look a different way. Jesus said in Luke 11, he was talking about beware of the things that the Pharisees, the way that they do things. And in the message, it talks about how they're wearing a mask, but that mask is going to slip. And it's hard work putting up a mask. It's hard work. It's a lot of effort, you know, doing things in the natural apart from him. But in him, when you just, you know, humble yourself and say, Lord, I need your help. He makes things go well for us. He makes our plans. He establishes our plans. And he causes our plans. He causes us to both will and do of his good pleasure. And then we want what he wants. And we go after what he wants. Because it's a way greater life. Amen? Colossians chapter 2 and verse 3. It says, in whom, and is speaking here of Jesus in the verse before, in whom are hid all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. In him, in Jesus, there are hidden treasures. Remember that John, the first chapter, said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And then down in verse 14, the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Who is Jesus? He's the living Word. In God's Word, and his Word was manifested in the person of Jesus, are hid all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. I don't know about you, but I like seeking treasures of wisdom and knowledge. I'm hungry for more wisdom. God's wisdom. I'm hungry for his knowledge. And, you know, like Kim, I reached a point in life where I realized I can keep seeking in this direction, but it just seemed like I kind of came to a fork in the road. And I needed to go after him more than I needed to go after my plans or my pursuits. And I'm so thankful for that. Let's look at one more place here before we get to preaching really good. Proverbs chapter 3. Kim, do you have the Message translation? I want to read this in the Message. Proverbs 3, verses 13. I'll start in verse 13 and we'll read several verses here. I moved. Sorry. It says this, you're blessed when you meet Lady Wisdom, when you make friends with Madam Insight. She's worth far more than money in the bank. Her friendship is better than a big salary. Her value exceeds all the trappings of wealth. Nothing you can wish for holds a candle to her. With one hand she gives long life, with the other she confers recognition. Her manner is beautiful, her life wonderfully complete. She's the very tree of life to those who embrace her. Hold her tight and be blessed. With Lady Wisdom, God formed earth, and with Madam Insight, he raised heaven. They knew when to signal rivers and springs to the surface, and dew to descend from the night skies. By wisdom, God created. You know, by his words he spoke, and the sand of the seashore held the sea back. God's word is powerful. God's wisdom is unsearchable. You know, I got a hold of some things here in Proverbs once. I remember some verses in the third chapter. And you don't have to turn there, but I'll just say them to you. It says, get wisdom, get understanding, forget it not. And as I started seeing and understanding the connection between the word of God and the wisdom of God, because the wisdom of God is the word of God. Remember that verse we read? Jesus, the living word, is made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption. We have the mind of Christ. Amen? So, I began to see that connection, and I just inserted this here where it says, get wisdom. I said it like this, get the word of God. And everywhere where it says wisdom or refers to wisdom with the pronoun there, I would just replace it with the word of God. So it sounds like this, get the word of God, get understanding, forget the word of God not, neither decline from the words of my mouth. Forsake the word of God not, and the word of God will preserve you. Love the word of God, and the word of God will keep you. The word of God is the principal thing. Therefore, get the word of God. And with all thy getting, get understanding. Exalt the word of God, and the word of God shall promote you. The word of God shall bring you to honor when you embrace the word of God. The word of God will give to your head an ornament of grace. A crown of glory shall the word of God deliver unto you. This is true. And I can tell you from my life, there's no greater life. I mean, I've never had it so good. I love this life in Jesus and this life in the Word. I love how he's set up my life. I'm blessed. And I can tell you that it's not because of anything I did. It's because of what Jesus did. It's just I cooperated with it. That's all. I just believed what he did, believed what he said, and I sought after him. You know, this book tells us over and over, if we'll seek him, then he'll add to us. If we'll do the one thing that's necessary, then he'll make all the other things go well. There's favor for people that do things with God and God's way. Amen? Remember Joseph? It says the Lord was with him. It said that everyone that he met up with noticed the Lord is with him. Something's different about him. And because of that, they would, you know, want him to be in charge and oversee their things, their natural things. And he would. And there would be great success come to those things because Joseph was such an amazing man. No? What makes us amazing? What really distinguishes us from other people on earth? Is it our clothing? It's not our hair. What distinguishes us? Moses, I remember in Exodus 33, I believe it is, he said, unless your presence goes with us, I don't want to go. It's his presence. It's him being with us. And he makes the difference. It's him. And we don't have a lot to give of us to people, but we have everything to give when we're in him, because we're not our